cement makes a putty putty. Cement makes a putty putty.
Portland cement, a common item that we associate with construction. Did you know that it was first produced in the United States right here in the Lehigh Valley? Before Columbus even stumbled upon the Americas, Romans were well known for their use of cement. They built structures like bathhouses and the Colosseum, but after the fall of their civilizations, the secret of it producing cement was lost. Later on, humans rediscovered cement and even improved upon it. The British first started using Portland cement, a better and stronger version of natural cement. David Saylor heard about the wonders of Portland cement as well and brought its strength to the Lehigh Valley in 1875.
First, you get some gravel, pour it in the vault.
Let's rewind to a few years earlier to the creation of David Saylor's company, the Copley Cement Company. In 1866, Saylor and his two partners began producing cement. They used raw materials from around the area to create their cement. The proper amounts of materials in that rock were suited perfectly to make cement. Not many areas had such luck with their resources. To make the cement, they mixed limestone and clay and heated it. Afterwards, it was ground up, which resulted in the final product.
In 1875, Saylor heard about Portland cement, which the British had started using in place of natural cement. With the help of Lehigh University, he discovered what was in Portland cement. He decided to make it himself, which was good for his business, as no one else in the U.S. had started to produce it. By 1884, Copley Cement was producing 30 million pounds of Portland cement each year. Some of the projects and buildings that contain Saylor's Portland cement include the Lincoln Memorial, the Amphitheater at the Arlington National Cemetery, New York's Woolworth Building, and the Drexel Building in Philadelphia.
You mix a mess of mortar, you add some meth and water, see the Mallaroonie come out, slurp, slurp, slurp.
Copley Cement was not the only cement business in the area. Lehigh Portland Cement was founded in 1897. The first cement kiln where they made the cement was constructed in Ormrod. With demand of construction materials going up, Lehigh Portland Cement found themselves as the largest company by 1920. During that period, they produced 12 million barrels of cement per year. However, their booming business was short-lived because the demand for cement decreased during the 1930s. They are now owned by Heidenberger Cement.
Cement makes a putty putty. Cement makes a putty putty.
Who wants a bucket of cement?
Atlas Cement was another major cement business in the area. It was started in 1889 by the Navarros family. They originally named it the Keystone Company, but soon after, in 1890, they changed the name to the Atlas Cement Company. Some people just refer to it as the Atlas. What makes the Atlas famous is that they were the first to use the rotary kiln in the area. The Navarros family first heard about the new kiln from England. The Atlas Cement Company further developed, eventually having 78 kilns that covered 200 acres. The plant was the largest in the world. These kilns were extremely hot, as they were fired to 2,800 degrees. The kilns churned out cement day and night, providing cement to projects like the Panama Canal, the Empire State Building, and Rockefeller Center. 151,000 barrels of cement were used in the Empire State Building.
Cement makes a putty putty. Cement makes a putty putty.
Some people remember buildings and clothing being covered with cement dust because of how much concrete the businesses produced. We can even see how much the cement business is still a part of people's memories and traditions. If you'd like to learn more about the cement industry in our area, you can visit the Saylor Park and Cement Industry Museum or the Atlas Cement Company Memorial Museum.
Thank you.
first you get some gravel, pour it in the bout. To mix a mess of mortar, you add cement and water. See the Mallaroonie come out, slurp, slurp, slurp.
Cement mixer, putty, putty.
Who wants a bucket of cement?